So when it comes to amino acid supplementation in general, BCAAs have been the top choice for most lifters for many years now. They're still a top-selling supplement, and a lot of people use them pre-workout, intra-workout, or even post-workout as a way to stimulate protein synthesis and prevent muscle breakdown. Now, I've made quite a few videos about BCAAs in the past and talked a lot about them on my blog and my Instagram, basically explaining that when it all comes down to it, they're really just a complete waste of money, and that if you just eat enough protein from your regular diet, which is pretty easy to do at about 0.8 grams of protein per pound of body weight daily, if you do that, you'll already be getting all the BCAAs that you need, and supplementing with additional BCAAs on top of that isn't going to give you any extra anabolic or anti-catabolic effect. And fortunately, the research just keeps piling up on this, and I'd say at this point, among most what you'd call, I guess, evidence-based fitness coaches, there's really no debate about BCAAs at all, in the sense that we essentially know that they literally don't do anything other than give you a possible placebo effect. And besides the fact that your regular protein intake will already be giving you enough BCAAs as is, the other reason why they just don't work is because even though BCAAs do technically stimulate protein synthesis, you still need to take in the full spectrum of essential amino acids along with them in order to actually carry out the muscle building process. So taking BCAAs is sort of like calling construction workers to a site, but then not providing them with any materials to actually build anything. And so because of this, now we're starting to see more people pushing essential amino acid supplements, which still provide the three branched chain amino acids, but also the additional spectrum of essential amino acids as well, in order to produce a more complete muscle building effect. And yes, on a head-to-head basis, an essential amino acid supplement would be superior to a pure BCAA supplement, but the same logic here applies. And the same logic holds true at the end of the day. If you're just eating enough protein from your regular diet, your essential amino acid needs are already going to be fully met, and just dumping more and more on top of it isn't going to give you any sort of added muscle building effect. Your body can only make use of a limited amount of amino acids each day for the purpose of gaining muscle, and you can't just force additional growth by going beyond that point. It's really that simple. Now, the other question is in regards to fasted training. This is the other main situation where people commonly use essential amino acid supplements as a way to prevent muscle breakdown during the session. And I do agree that getting in some protein slash amino acids pre-workout is probably ideal if you want to fully maximize your gains. The difference would probably be fairly small either way, as long as you're eating enough total protein for the day as a whole. But yeah, for 100% optimal muscle growth and maintenance, completely fasted training probably isn't going to be ideal. However, if you're planning to use EAAs for that purpose, you'll actually be better off to just use regular protein powder instead. See, people have this misconception that BCAAs or EAAs are zero calorie, and they're basically just free amino acids that you can add into your diet, when in reality, all amino acids contain calories, and on a gram for gram basis, they're pretty much on par with regular dietary protein. So whether you use BCAAs, EAAs, or 20 grams of whey protein, you're technically no longer fasted anyway, not to mention that there's no special benefit to training fasted in the first place, other than it just being a matter of personal preference if you just feel better training that way. And the reality is that regular protein is actually going to be superior to an essential amino acid supplement because it's going to provide you with the full spectrum of all of the aminos and their natural ratios. The big problem that I see with most EAA supplements is that a lot of them use proprietary blends, meaning they just lump together all of the amino acids into one mixture, and then they list the total amount for all of the aminos combined, but not the specific dosage per amino acid. And literally, the only real reason supplement companies use proprietary blends in the first place is just as a way to cut costs, because that way, what they can do is front load the cheapest amino acids into the blend and include those ones in higher amounts, and then just sprinkle in whatever amount they want of the more expensive ones. So the label might list off an amino acid matrix that's 10 grams in total, and then have cheap amino acids like taurine at the very start of the list. And for all you know, there could be 8 grams of taurine in that blend, and then just a tiny amount of all of the other amino acids. For the most part, if any supplement company uses a proprietary blend on their label, it's because they're trying to hide something, and there's something in there that they don't want you to see. Otherwise, they'd have no real reason to use one. And it's just a huge red flag, and it's reason enough to avoid that particular product, in my opinion. And then for the amino acid supplements, the essential amino acid supplements that don't use proprietary blends, most of them still seem to prioritize the BCAAs first and foremost, and then they only include a much smaller amount of the rest of the essential aminos, in which case those products should ultimately be avoided as well. So at the end of the day, there's just no good reason to use an essential amino acid supplement over a standard protein powder if you're looking to get more EAAs into your diet in a convenient way, or if you're training fasted, which I put in quotes because, again, you're technically not fasted if you ingest amino acids of any kind prior to training. So the protein powder, whether it's whey, egg, casein, a blend of some kind, or even a good plant-based powder, that's going to give you the full natural spectrum of amino acids in a convenient liquid form, just like an EAA supplement. And on top of that, it's going to be more cost-effective on a gram-for-gram basis as well. You are going to get a tiny bit of extra carbs and fats from the protein powder, but the amounts in there are going to be so small that they really aren't going to matter in the overall scheme. And if you are that paranoid about, you know, a couple grams of carbs or a gram or two of fat here and there, and you really want to fully minimize it for some reason, then you can just purchase a whey isolate, which contains almost no carbs or fat and is basically just pure protein. So that's really all there is to it here, guys. BCAAs and EAAs are ultimately both unnecessary supplements. You can easily get all the amino acids you need for optimal gains from your regular diet. And if you're looking for a convenient way to get in a higher amount of essential amino acids, whether it's before your workout or just in general, because you know, maybe your whole food protein intake is lacking a little bit, a basic protein powder is gonna be your best bet. And a lot of people have been asking me about it, but at the time of this video, Real Science Athletics doesn't offer a protein powder product, but it's definitely something that we'll be adding in down the line. For now, we have available our pre-workout formula, athlete's multivitamin, and fish oil, and I genuinely believe that these are the best formulated products in their categories right now. And you can check them out by visiting us over at realscienceathletics.com using the link up here or in the description box below. And you can also use coupon code YouTube10 to save 10% off your entire first order. Thanks for watching, guys. Make sure to hit the like button, leave a comment, and subscribe below if you haven't already in order to stay up to date on future videos. And I'll see you in the next one.